Laparoscopic ligation of the uterine arteries at its origin is a useful tool in case of hysterectomy for large uteri or for large myomas when myomectomy is required. The first step to performing this is adhesiolysis and adequate exposure. As in the case of this patient who has some endometriosis and bowel adhesions posteriorly, first, the bowel adhesions to the posterior surface of the uterus are released using a bipolar sealer and cutter. This is the same instrument that we are going to be using throughout the duration of this surgery. So after doing the required adhesiolysis, then we start taking a look at the lateral pelvic wall where the uterine artery ligation is going to be performed. The first step in this is lysis of the congenital bowel adhesions. We always see that the sigmoid colon is adherent to the left adnexal area, and these adhesions need to be cleared off for a few centimeters, at least till the impression of the iliac vessels start being visible, because this is the area that we are going to use to approach the great vessels and further down to find the ureter and then the uterine artery before ligating it. The dissection starts with gaining entry to the retroperitoneum. Although there are several ways to do this, one of the easiest ways to gain access to the retroperitoneum is by cutting the round ligament and then extending the incision from the round ligament to the infundibulopelvic ligament, keeping the line of incision about 1 cm parallel and lateral to the infundibulopelvic ligament. This exposes the great vessels. And the other advantage of this particular technique over the posterior technique is that in this technique, there is more space available to the operating surgeon. Once the surgeon becomes more and more comfortable with the pelvic wall structures, he or she can choose to open the retroperitoneum in multiple different ways and perform uterine artery ligation in several other ways, which actually may be quicker. However, proceeding by this way makes sure that the surgeon will be able to see all the vital structures in the pelvis and not confuse one structure from the other before the uterine artery ligation is performed. So as the incision is extended up till the infundibulopelvic ligament, the loose areolar tissue of the retroperitoneum starts becoming visible. Once this loose areolar tissue is seen, the next step is to hold the loose areolar tissue and to start cutting it so as to cut the transverse fibers that are seen between the anterior and posterior folds of the broad ligament. As these transverse fibers are gently dissected, it is a good idea to cauterize and cut them, or to use a harmonic here at this stage, because only blunt dissection will result in a lot of bleeding here. Once some of the transverse fibers have been divided, the first structure that is seen laterally is the external iliac artery, and underneath it the external iliac vein. Once this structure has been identified, more transverse fibers can be safely divided at this level, combining sharp dissection along with blunt dissection using the bipolar cautery or preferably a harmonic scalpel, so as to move the transverse fibers away and separate the anterior and posterior leaves of the broad ligament from each other. Once some more dissection has been performed and the transverse fibers have been cut, a structure starts becoming apparent on the medial leaf of the broad ligament, which is the ureter. Here, the ureter is shown by the red arrow. The ureter can be identified by its peristalsis and also by the leash of blood vessels that it carries around it. Also, sometimes a vein can be seen running along the course of the ureter in its entire length. Once the ureter has been definitively identified, dissection continues lateral to the ureter in the pararectal space, gradually dividing the transverse fibers that are covering the lateral surface of the ureter. And the surgeon attempts to continue this dissection more and more cranially or towards the bladder. Once these transverse fibers have been divided, the dissection reaches a point where the ureter apparently turns anteriorly and becomes invisible from the field of view. This is its entry point into the ureteric tunnel, where, as per anatomy, the ureter crosses over between the uterine artery, which runs on top of it, and the superficial uterine vein, which runs below the ureter. Making use of these anatomical principles, we start dissecting lateral to the ureter at this point in an attempt to find the uterine vessels. Again, the uterine artery at this point is the first structure to cross the pararectal space from the lateral side to the medial side. Therefore, we do a dissection in order to find this structure which is crossing the pararectal space transversely. These uterine vessels have now started becoming apparently visible. However, we need to differentiate between the uterine artery and the uterine vein. So dissection continues at this point, slowly clearing off the fascia. The assistant is now asked to extend his grasper and to place it over the ureter in order to keep the ureter out of harm's way. And it also serves as a marker to make sure that dissection does not inadvertently cause any lateral spread of current to the ureter by remaining in close proximity to the ureter. So the fascia at this level is gently dissected away in an attempt to find the uterine artery. As more and more dissection is done, after a while, a pulsatile structure starts becoming visible just lateral to the crossing point of the ureter. This pulsatile structure, which is now seen, is the uterine artery. The uterine artery may appear blue in color sometimes, contrary to elsewhere in the body where it always appears at a darker color. Once the uterine artery is identified, the uterine artery can be held with a forceps without any risk of damaging the uterine artery, and keeping the ureter under view at all times, the fascia around the uterine artery is now dissected away gently. Again, the uterine artery is held and the fascia under the uterine artery is being dissected away in an effort to separate the uterine artery from the uterine vein. Once this separation is done, now we can now see that the uterine artery is in the surgeon's left hand or on the top grasper, and the uterine vein is seen below pointed by the lower red arrow. And between these two structures, we can see the ureter safely entering into the ureteric tunnel. So the uterine artery is on top, the vein below, and the ureter entering in the fork between the two. Once this is done, the uterine artery has now been dissected completely and can be ligated using any means required. The uterine artery may be usually ligated at its center point, so it is lifted away from the surrounding structures, making sure that the ureter is away, that the uterine vein will not get injured. And after that, it can either be coagulated using bipolar current, as we are going to do in this case, or one may pass a ligature around it or put clips at the uterine artery. Any of these methods is equally and perfectly safe, so long as the ureter is in your view and is out of harm's way by whatever methodology that you may choose to adopt. So the uterine artery now has been sealed. It is not necessary to divide the uterine artery at all times. Just sealing the uterine artery using either a harmonic scalpel or by using bipolar energy is good enough to stop the flow of blood and therefore to achieve hemostasis. The internal iliac artery is also seen here, from where the uterine artery takes its origin. This second part of the video illustrates the distance between the uterine artery when bipolar coagulation is applied and the ureter, which is there in the lateral pelvic wall. And you can see that if adequate traction is given from the vaginal end, there is a distance of at least 4 to 5 centimeters between the two, and so bipolar current can be safely used. This does not require prior lateral pelvic wall dissection and is just an illustrative example that if adequate traction is given from the vaginal end or by using a myoma screw, the ureter will never be in harm's way as long as adequate precautions and excessive use of energy is not undertaken. If you liked the video, please click on the icon above to subscribe to our channel to keep receiving more such updates. Thank you.